Penguin Random House Audio presents Marvel. What if Marc Spector was host to Venom? A Moon Knight and Venom story by Mike Chen. Read for you by Xavier Casals and Keith Szarabajka. For all of the odd couples outliving their best lives across the multiverse. Transcript of video interview. Office of Dr. Emmett. Retrograde Sanitarium. Interview subject, Marc Spector, 2:15 p.m. Clinical diagnosis, dissociative identity disorder. Notable issues, violent outbursts, delusions of grandeur, detachment from reality. Dr. Emmett. Recording started at 2:15. Sodium pentothal administered 15 minutes prior. For patient's own safety, limbs have been restrained to the chair. How are you, Marc? Did you have a good lunch? Marc Spector. Your truth serum actually tastes better than your cafeteria. Hell, my marine rations tasted better than your cafeteria. Unfortunately, I can't influence the food service vendor. That's the facilities department. I don't know why you even gave me a shot. I got nothing to hide.
Good. Then we'll make progress today. Tell me about the two identities you stole. First, Stephen Grant. Who is he?
Stephen's an arrogant billionaire who spends too much time indulging in his fantasies.
All right. And where does Stephen Grant live?
In my head.
And Jake Lockley. Who is he?
Cab driver. Tough SOB. Impulsive, ruthless at times. Blood doesn't bother him.
And where does he live?
In my head. One big, unhappy family in this skull.
You see, that's simply not true. You've stolen and integrated their identities as part of your own persona. Grant's got a really nice mansion on Long Island and a penthouse in Midtown. Look. Here are the public records of purchase.
Sounds of shuffling paper.
Lockley keeps his own shabby place somewhere. Wouldn't want to imagine the number of rats in the walls. I will say, though, the one person who is sharing your headspace is this Khonshu.
Yeah, he's there too.
It's a good thing I'm an Egyptology buff. Khonshu, as in the Egyptian god of the moon.
Heliopolis.
Excuse me?
Egyptian gods are actually interdimensional beings. They reside in a place known as Heliopolis.
I see. Anything else you want to tell me about Khonshu?
Yeah. He's got an attitude problem.
Noted. Egyptian god with an attitude problem that travels between dimensions and hires former mercenaries like Marc Spector. Now, tell me about Gina Landers and Jean-Paul Duchamp.
Pauses. Why are you bringing up Gina and Frenchie?
Oh, didn't you hear? They're new patients here at Retrograde.
They don't belong here, Marc.
Marc. They participate in your delusion. That means they are delusional as well. Delusional people are a danger to society. Fortunately, their support in your endeavors led us directly to them, so we can help them, like we are helping you.
Your help?
Yes, exactly. For them and the general public. Gina runs a diner. Who knows how the delusions would affect her cooking? That's a public safety issue. Duchamp, Frenchy, as you call him, former mercenary like you, right? Good with weapons, flies helicopters, probably just as much PTSD as you, and not the type of person you want with firearms. So yes, they belong here.
Pauses.
How's that sodium pentothal treating you? Feeling more relaxed?
I can't relax. Sound of chair rattling. Stephen can. Jake can. I can't.
All right. One more name for you. Tell me about Marlene Alraune.
Sound of chair slamming. If you hurt...
Ah, see, there you go. Violent outbursts. I'm glad to see those restraints are working. Billy, will you please tighten them?
Sound of grunts and clicking.
You see how we are looking out for you? You can't contain yourself.
Sound of papers shuffling.
Isn't that why Marlene left you? My gosh, you sure introduced some difficult times into her life. And her dad, Peter. That's Egyptologist Peter Alraune, for the record. He died around you as well. That's not a great start to any relationship. Actually, let me check. How many times has she left you?
Pauses. Twice.
Good. Honesty. And why did she leave you?
She didn't want my life of violence to affect her anymore.
Exactly. Now we're getting to the core of it.
Sounds of rustling.
This suit, you call it Moon Knight. You hurt people in it. That's a problem. Let's see, some of the things you've claimed in our notes. How many battles with Bushmen? A werewolf? And take a look at this photo. You called it a siphon, and you claimed to have defeated, and I quote, a multiversal version of Moon Knight called Moon Shade to get it.
Where'd you get that?
That doesn't matter. Are you listening to yourself? Does this sound like something any rational person would say? Give me an honest answer.
Pauses. No, it doesn't.
Good. Every step forward is important. This is why I find you so fascinating. In fact, I'd say it's the culmination of my life's work to help you. Now, what should we get to next?
Pauses. I'll tell you what I'm going to do next. I'm going to bust out of here. Tonight. I'm going to take what's mine. My friends, my suit. I'm done with this hellhole. You think you can break me? I've seen far, far worse.
As long as we're being honest here, how do you plan to do that? Do you have a lockpick hidden away? A shiv made of soap?
No. I don't need those things.
Then what do you have?
Jake, Stephen, Khonshu. They're all I'll need. They're all I can rely on. You'll see.
I think we're done here. Time is 24 minutes past 2. Billy, Mr. Spector needs another round of sedatives and electroshock therapy. Maximum strength.
The Vastness of Space. America. America Chavez was in trouble, and she knew it. Not that long ago, such an instinct would be elusive, invisible to her. She'd been lost for so long, awash in the dreamlike state of whatever had become her existence. But now, she felt like herself, even though things had changed. This trouble was different from the chaos of her childhood, or the battles of her teenage years. This time, the conflict came from the people she thought were on her side. The Watchers. Problem was, the Watchers weren't always right, which caused a bit of an issue given that America trusted her gut. And when she tried to explain this to the Watchers, they told her to stand down, stop intervening, leave people like Peter Parker and Stephen Strange alone. The Watchers or her gut instinct? She chose her gut instinct. And she was right. Because someone was involved.
a mystery foe, someone whose actions echoed across time and space and reality. No, beyond reality, multiple realities, possibly all realities. And with it came a single identity, someone cloaked in the shadows, and through all of the collective
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.